Students will take one more numerical, that is question number 3. Let us see the question graphically, then we'll solve. I have an inclined plane like so, and the object is placed in this inclined plane like this. The object has mass of 4 kilogram, is released. The object of mass 4 kilogram is released at this point, and this surface has some friction. This has some friction, say 0.5. I will consider that this angle is say I will take 30 degree. Okay, so this is the angle 30 degree. This is a block of mass 4 kg is released and the surface has some friction. So now the question is, there can be various types of questions that can be put. One is whether the block will slide or not slide. So first, that is the question that you have to find, if block slides or not. So we'll see if the block slides or not. First, that will check. Second, so because I have taken this from my own mind, so I don't know whether it will slide or not. So first we'll check that. After that, I will make other questions. Okay, so let us see. So as far as this particular part is concerned, now if the block has to move down, because it will never move up, that is for sure. If you keep any object on an inclined plane like this, then definitely either it will stay there or it will fall down like this, slide down. But if you put it here, it will not never move off. So that part is very clear. So we'll see first whether it is moving down or not. What force is responsible for E2 for this downward motion? That we'll see here. Let us draw a free body diagram. Here, this is the weight mg that is acting on this block. I resolve this block force into two components, one along this and another along this. This angle is 30 or theta. I will call this also theta, that is 30. So I will take a general angle theta. So this component is mg cos theta, and this component is mg sin theta. So what we have done is we have resolved this mg, the weight, into two components, one along the horizontal, along the inclined plane, and another perpendicular to it. Now, because the block is in contact with the inclined plane, there will be normal reaction. So I'll show normal reaction with another color I will use. Suppose this is a normal reaction. This is a normal reaction force that will act normal to this surface. So obviously, it should not be in this direction. It should not be in the direction of mg, as in the case of earlier cases, because you know that when a block is placed on a horizontal surface, its weight is downward and normal direction is upward. But this is not the case in case of inclined plane. The normal reaction is not in the direction of weight. It might be direction, or it always in the direction of the inclined plane, the direction of the perpendicular to the direction of the surface in which it is kept. So in case of horizontal surface, normal reaction and weight will be in the same direction. But in case of inclined plane, as you can see here, the normal reaction is not in the direction, opposite direction of mg, because mg is like this, and the normal reaction is not like this, as in the case here. Okay, normal reaction is always normal to the surface. Here it is normal to the surface. Here also, this is normal to the surface. Now, then we have to find what is the frictional force, maximum value of frictional force. That we'll find the maximum value of frictional force, that is FL, limiting friction. How much it is that? Mu s into n. What is mu s? 0.5 is in the question. What is n? Now n is equal to mg cos theta. Okay, now n is equal to mg cos theta. You can see this line, that line, this n and this mg cos theta will be equal, because when the block slides or doesn't slide, there is no movement in this direction. I can call this as x direction and this as y direction. So there is no movement of the block in the y direction. So therefore, these two forces in this direction must be same. Therefore, n is equal to mg sin theta. Okay. Now putting the value, we get 0.5. mg is how much? M is 4, g is 10. So 4 into g, 4 into 10, 40. So write 4, 10, 40. Cos theta, theta is 60. Theta is 30 here, I will write 30. Cos 30. So how much is now? Now cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Okay. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2. This is 0.5, this is 4, this is 10. That you all multiply and see how much you are getting. Now this is 4, cancels. This is root 3. Root 3 is 1.73 into 10. So probably it will be 17.3. Students, I was telling you that the maximum frictional force is 17.3 Newton. So now this is the maximum up to which it can prevent. Now if I put a block on the inclined plane, it has a tendency to slide. What is the force which is making it to slide? It is mg sin theta. As you can see here, this is the force, this is the component of gravitational force which is acting along the inclined plane, and it is responsible for the downward motion of this block. Now what is its value? That also we have to find out, because this plays a role in the downward motion. Now let us find out that downward force that is acting along the block is m g sin theta. Let us find out that m is 4. This comes out to be 2, so it is 20. 20 Newton force is acting downward, and friction has the maximum of 17.3. That means the body will slide down, because this gravitational force that is pulling it in this direction is more than the maximum value of friction force. Therefore, the free body diagram for this will be, as you can see here, friction in this direction will be 17.3, and mg sin theta, because of mg sin theta, 20 will act in the direction. So therefore the difference is downward, so it will move downward. The first thing is, if the block slides or not, yes, the answer is yes, it will slide. Okay, the block will slide. Now the next question we can make is, if it slides, find the acceleration of the block. Okay, so let us find the acceleration of the block. Find the acceleration of the block down the plane. Now this was the situation. 17.3 Newton is acting up because of frictional force. 20 Newton force was acting downward because of the gravitational force. Its mass is 4 kg. So therefore, along this line, the acceleration is net force divided by mass. That is 20 minus 17.3 divided by 4, which is this is 2.7 divided by 4. That is whatever is the case, that is 2.7 by 4 meter per second square. This is the answer to this question. So therefore, this is how you find the acceleration. And now if I say how much extra force is needed to to prevent the block from sliding down, then obviously you will say it is a 2.7, because if I apply 2.7 in this direction, there will be no motion of this block. If I say, if I apply a force of 20 newton in, or more than 20 newton in the upper direction, suppose I apply a force of 25 newton, then what will happen to the friction? That is the question. What is the friction if 25 newton force? Is applied off the plane. 25 newton applied off the plane. 20 newton is always there because of gravity. Now what will happen? Now the interesting point is that when I apply a 25 newton force, and this is 20, the net force is 5 newton upward. So because the net force is 5 newton upward, that there is a tendency of this body moving in the upper direction, therefore the friction will act in the downward direction. So in this case the friction will be in the downward direction, so therefore friction will act in this direction. And can the body move? The answer is obviously no, because the friction, we have calculated that its maximum value last time, it was 17.3. So therefore, it can provide. Now what is the friction in this case will be? The friction that is acting, FL is this, but the friction that will act in this case is only 5 newton, because this will prevent, because 20 is already there, 5 will be there, 25, so there will be no acceleration. So in this case, the friction that will act, the in this case is 5 newton down the plane. So you must remember there will be no acceleration. Then what should be the maximum force you apply for there is no acceleration? Then obviously you can say 20 newton is there, it will be always there, and FL is 17.3, so if you add them, there is 37.3. So if the force applied in this direction, is more than 37.3, then only the block will start moving upward. Okay, thank you.